it's always been a question of mine. Why? What drives people to be physically active, especially throughout their lifetime? How's that feel? We're hoping to show for the first time and actually demonstrate what happens within the area of the brain, the prefrontal cortex, during exercise that pushes you to your maximal effort. Our hypothesis, and there's strong evidence to suggest that this might be the case, is that because children lack this cognitive and cerebral infrastructure to regulate how they feel, that might be the underlying mechanism that kind of explains why children have these poor experiences often with fitness testing. So we'll have a mask that kind of looks like a fighter pilot mask on with a tube coming out of it that measures the expired gases. They'll have this device on their head that measures brain activation. And they will be riding a pediatric bike, which will be computer controlled and will automatically increase the intensity until the point where they decide to quit.
We know that participation in physical activity and exercise has emotional consequences across the lifespan, no matter who you are. Even though this is a society that is in need of higher levels of physical activity, I would say an even desperate need of higher levels of physical activity, a lot of the things that we do as individuals progress from childhood to adolescence to adulthood are not optimal in terms of creating positive affective memories or emotional memories. So if the promotion of fitness and skill entails that a large, perhaps even the larger percentage of children derive unpleasant experiences and unpleasant memories, I think we need to look very critically at that situation and consider what can be changed. So what we want to do is reignite, re-spark a conversation, national conversation, and suggest the idea that we need to be mindful of what the ultimate objective of physical education is. And I think we can all agree, on a philosophical level anyway, that the objective should be to establish a lifelong physical activity habit.
During the test, we'll be looking at psychological variables. So we have a scale that basically measures how they're feeling in that moment, and we'll be measuring that throughout the test to see whether or not, as the intensity gets more difficult, do children have more and more unpleasant experiences. So for the first time, we're actually going to be able to see live within a test that a lot of kids have to do in physical education, what the majority of children are experiencing during that activity.
In order to establish a physical activity habit, children need to leave school with a pleasant taste in their mouth. That physical education and movement and physical activity in general are enjoyable things, positive things, opportunities that they should seek out as opposed to avoid. The prime objective must always be to keep the children active and the adults active.
We try to figure out a way to make it so that physical activity is more pleasantly associated than that sedentary behavior. And we think that that may be key to helping people get up off the couch.